about the importance of Sanskrit and the importance of recitation from a very early age. Sanskrit, as we know, is the mother of all languages. It is also the most scientific, precise and phonetic language, which means it is pronounced exactly the way it is written. People who know Sanskrit can very easily learn other languages. They gain access to the priceless treasure of ancient Indian knowledge in many fields such as medicine, arts and science. The new research also points to the fact that Sanskrit as a language is highly suitable for many areas of computer science. We should all be proud of the fact that schools across the world have now started including Sanskrit as a part of their official curriculum. Bhagavad Gita is one of the most valuable sources of learning in Sanskrit language available to us. There are many benefits of learning Gita recitation from very early age. Children who regularly recite Gita exhibit clear speech and accurate pronunciation. Now please note that kids may not understand the meaning of these verses at this age, but we surely hope that as they grow up, they will hopefully want to learn the meaning of these verses as well. This session, my primary responsibility was teaching the 12th adhyay of Bhagavad Gita to the batch of senior kids. In the past, we have mostly focused on teaching simple shlokas and subhashitas to these children. So now learning to recite Bhagavad Gita was a very big jump for them. For one, they not only need to remember the individual shloka, but they also need to remember the entire sequence in order to recite the adhyaya correctly. Many shlokas in Gita have similar words but with slight differences in different lines. So kids need to be really focused to get all these nuances right in their recitation. Some of you may already know that some words in Bhagavad Gita are very, very long and complex to pronounce. So for example, Dhyanat Karana Padat Tyagas Tyagat Chantiranantaram is one single word in the 12th Adhyay of Bhagavad Gita. Apart from this, there are specific rules of how Anusvaras, Visargas, Rasva and Dirgha Matras are pronounced in the Adhyaya. And these bad senior children have worked very, very hard to not only learn the Adhyaya but pronounce it accurately when they recite. They have actually done a very phenomenal job in this Adhyaya and you will soon see their energy in action. And apart from Bhagavad Gita Adhyaya, we have also spent a lot of time learning a lot of life skills. So for the first time, we have tried to use the audio visual medium in our classes. We have tried to show short 1 to 2 minute videos in the class about various habits such as importance of reading, reducing gadget addiction, not eating junk food, not wasting food, and all these videos were followed by very interesting and engaging discussions. The kids have surprised me many times with their very smart opinions, with their honest views, and it has been an amazing experience teaching this batch of kids. In the process of teaching these kids, I have myself learned many things from them. Although this is the end of the session for us, I surely hope this is not end of our association and this rewarding association between us continues for many more sessions to come. So with this, I want to invite each child from the senior batch to talk about one habit that we have learned and that we have discussed in the classroom. So they have been given just 1 minute to present their ideas, but trust me, they have had many more opinions about this particular issue and we have had many interesting discussions about this in the classroom. So we are going to start with Alap. Can I have Alap? Yes, please come in. Not in the social circle, but social network. It's not
Yeah.